downtown Indianapolis for the second half of our CBS Sports NCAA basketball doubleheader. It's Kentucky and Indiana. Sean McDonough along with Quinn Buckner, happy to have you with us. A sea of red and blue. Even though we're in the heart of Indiana's capital city, this is considered a neutral site because the tickets have been evenly distributed. 20,000 to the blue-clad Wildcat fans and 20,000 given to those wearing the red of the Hoosiers. 39th meeting all time between these two proud programs and the starting lineups. For Kentucky, it's Walter McCarty and Derek Anderson at the forwards with Antoine Walker lining up at center this afternoon. Tony Delk and Anthony Epps, the guards. For Indiana, Brian Evans and Andre Patterson are the forwards. Harris Mujezinovic, and that's the first time, and we're one for one with some hesitation. Charlie Miller and Sharon Wilkerson, the backcourt. And Quinn, as we look at this matchup, Kentucky consensus number one in the preseason, but they've already stumbled with a loss against the University of Massachusetts earlier this week in the Grade 8. Rick Pitino told us this morning, our team has been overrated. We're a very good team. We're one of 12 or so with a chance to win the national championship, but we're no better than Kansas, UMass, Connecticut, etc. Meanwhile, Bob Knight and his Hoosiers come in at 2-2, and interesting to watch these two coaches today because they both want to control the tempo.
Yeah, I think that's really important for Bob Knight's team. UMass beat Kentucky because they were able to control the tempo. Now, granted, Marcus Camby had an excellent game, but the guards, when you think of Travieso, Padilla, they control the tempo. Got to have it happen today for Indiana to have a good shot at this game.
John Clogarty to throw the ball in the air. He's working with Tom O'Neill and Mike Sanzier as our officials, and Kentucky in blue controls the opening tip.
The first thing you can think about, we talk about the talent. Rick Pitino has settled in to get Tony Delk to his natural position, which is the two guard, and I think that's important for this game, as well as Anderson to defend.
And Anderson, who started at the two guard in the first two games, was fouled as he put up the shot. And the foul's on Brian Evans, the Hoosiers' best player, leading scorer and rebounder through four games. But Epps, more of the pure point guard. Delk moves back to shooting guard today. The experiment with Delk at the point didn't last very long for Kentucky. And Anderson has the first point of the game.
It doesn't last, and I think a good choice by Rick Pitino, because Tony Delk is a natural point guard, a two guard. He looks to shoot, and he needs to have that on the floor. So that's why they went back with him.
And Anderson starting it forward instead of the highly touted freshman Ron Mercer, because they feel Anderson will do a better job defensively on Brian Evans.
Just had a warning right there. John Clarkety gave Walter McCarty a warning so he doesn't come over. Next one will be a technical.
Charlie Miller pressured by Delk, and the Cats will pressure for the full 40 minutes. In transition, the layup goes for Andre Patterson.
Here's what's going to be important. When Kentucky runs it right back at you as quick as anybody in the country, as McCarty.
And McCarty with the dunk off the great feed from Anderson. And it's the 20,000 wearing blue who are erupting at the moment. Wilkerson double team. And Evans, they need to get it over the timeline. 3 seconds to do so as Wilkerson crossed midcourt. And he missed the layup. But it seems obvious, Quinn, the Indiana strategy is once you break the press, attack the basket.
Yeah, well, you've got to do that with a pressing team. You attack them and put them, and you've got to expose them to foul.
Rollicking start, no basket as Delk was fouled before the shot.
We talked about controlling the tempo early. This tempo is where Kentucky wants it. They run it back. McCarty gets the ball, and the reason he isn't called because he tried to protect himself from being hurt, so he is allowed to hold the rim.
Foul was on Charlie Miller, his first. 4-2 Kentucky. We've played 1 minute. Anderson, the transfer from Ohio State, with the layup.
See, I really thought this is why Rick Pitino made the switch to get Anderson in, because Brian Evans has to guard Anderson, and he can't. Anderson is their best all-around player.
And he's trying to pressure Wilkerson in the backcourt. Ron Wilkerson returning after sitting out all of last year. He fractured his left leg in the NCAA tournament in 1994. Missed all of last season.
Control the tempo, trying to make Kentucky play defense for 30 seconds.
And a three-point try for Patterson off the mark. They took the shot clock down to 5. The rebound cleared by Antoine Walker. And a three-pointer.
You have no room to back up. When Epps knocks down the jump shot, you have no room to back up on anybody on Kentucky when they're out on the floor.
First points for Epps. And Kentucky's out quickly at 9-2. Patterson dumped it to the baseline. And the easy one missed by Mujezinovic. This is the 39th meeting all time. Indiana leads the border rivalry 20 wins to 18, but Kentucky has won three of the last four, including last year at Freedom Hall in Louisville, a three-point decision, although Indiana had a six-point lead midway through the second half. Todd Lindemann has come in at center for Indiana. And Walker scores over Patterson, and it's all Kentucky in the first 2.5 minutes.
They're doing a great job getting the ball where they want. John Crockett has just called a technical foul on Antoine Walker for reaching over. He got the warning early in the game. A technical foul has been called, so this is the second violation. That's that eagerness that is trying to get after the basketball. They just got a little excited, and Rick Pitino rightfully is going to talk to McCarty and his entire team about, you know, let's do what we want to do fast, but let's do it smart.
And Evans to shoot the technical. He made the first. And the second. Uncharacteristically, Indiana has been a woeful free throw shooting team through its first four games this year. As a team coming into this one, 52% from the line. But Evans made both to cut the Kentucky lead to 7.
And that's huge when you think about Indiana teams who normally make more free throws than their opposition even attempts.
Miller shut off on the drive by Delk. Wilkerson couldn't handle the pass. Then Walker was fouled as he tried to break away. It was Patterson who committed the foul.
What you're watching with in this game is Bob Knight is bringing in Neil Reed, because at this point, Kentucky has been able to dominate the tempo, and particularly Sharon Wilkerson. He's playing so fast that he's playing right where Kentucky wants them to play, and Kentucky's a much better team at that pace.
Well, Kentucky has not missed a shot. 4-for-4 from the floor, 2-for-2 from the line, and the Cats lead by 7. McCarty can hit the three-pointer at 6'10". Wilkerson rebounded the miss, then was nearly stripped by Delk. And he was bumped by Walker. Well, that's two quick fouls on Antoine Walker, the sophomore from Chicago.
Well, Rick Pitino to the big bench right away. He's going to bring in Mark Polk, getting because of the quick foul there on Antoine Walker.
Pope, senior from Bellevue, Washington, another transfer. He came in after 2 years at the University of Washington. He was the Pac-10 Freshman of the Year for the Huskies in 91-92.
Got switched in the startup today because Rick Pitino wanted a faster lineup, a more athletic lineup out on the floor.
Evans and Delk up high for the rebound. Coach Pitino says inch for inch, Delk might be the best rebounder in the country. Delk says, I have to rebound. If I don't, Coach won't put me in the game. Oh, Henderson bumped on the drive by Evans. Evans gave him a shove.
He just picked
on
up
the
his
way
second
to the goal, and that's a big story for Indiana because so much of their offense is based on screening to get open jump shots for Evans.
Absolutely, and as we talked to Rick Pitino today, he said one of the reasons they lost to UMass is they didn't get people in foul trouble. But Brian Evans gets in foul trouble. He's the guy that scores the leading score. He's a fifth-year senior. He has everything they need on the floor for Indiana to be successful. And if he has to come off the floor, obviously that's going to impact the game.
Already 4 team fouls on Indiana. And Anderson to inbound. Still Delk and Epps the backcourt. Walker, Pope, and Anderson the front court for Kentucky. Anderson blocked by Patterson. Wilkerson 3-on-3. Blocked by Pope. And Lindemann lost it but went out off Kentucky. And Indiana will play it in, trailing 11-4.
You get a chance to take the ball, you push it anytime you can. But before that, you see the block there by Patterson. The ball got pushed to the other end, and then good defensive job by Polk to be able to block that last shot.
Patterson, long, dealt another rebound.
And up high for the rebound, yes, too.
Polk,
got to get there. He can stick it.
They all shoot threes on this Kentucky team. Walker, He rattles it in. So Walker put quickly back into the game by Rick Pitino with the two fouls.
Wanted to calm him down, settle him down a little bit, and then he goes up for the steal and gets it.
Reed lost the dribble. Walker lays it in. And Kentucky looking like the number one team in the country at the moment, leading by 11 at 15-4.
Well, one of the things that has to disappoint Bob Knight is the fact that when he put in Sharon Wilkerson and he brings in Neil Reed, he thinks he has his best ball handling team on the floor.
15 and a half remaining first half. Kentucky is dominating. Dealt 4-3.
Bob
and
Knight.
Coach Knight knows he'll get a TV timeout on the next whistle, but you wonder if he can wait.
That's what he's trying to do. He's trying to wait on the TV timeout.
18-4, Kentucky. Rick Pitino said this morning it's tough to force the tempo against Indiana, but the tempo is Kentucky. And Evans quiets the run with a three.
Well, Kentucky is just a much better, they have much better athletes, so they can get up and down the court and make plays that Indiana just won't make. If it's not a basketball game, Indiana doesn't have a chance. Just more of a track meet, Kentucky's got this easily.
Pope leaned in, offensive foul. First foul on Pope, and our first timeout comes with 14:53 remaining in the first half, and the Cats leading by 11.
Canon, now you can. Everyone on the network wants the power to do everything. Print a page, print 100, collate them, file them, find them, fax them, copy them, right from their desks. The answer? It's simple. Canon has the system that is the solution. The GP Series Digital Imaging System. Canon. Now you can.
I do not drive to work. I do not drive to get from point A to point B. I do not drive to run away from the world. I just love to drive.
The new 1996 Monte Carlo. Personal space from Genuine Chevrolet.
Hey, you'll get a charge out of this. We're watching college hoops, okay? The fans are totally energized. The teams come out and amped up like a heavyweight title bout in Vegas, and suddenly, this light bulb goes on over our heads. You know what would look cool on these guys? Well, the mess of college teams got totally turned on by their look. So, boom, that's what they're wearing this year. Now let me flash something else by you, okay? All that stuff? Converse, Converse, Converse. I know what you're thinking, man. Converse? Whoa, I'm shocked.
Think, Howie. Why is your throat, your cough, your fever all feel worse?
Because it's nighttime, and you can dwell on it.
Take what you used during the day.
Well, you'll still be up all night coughing. Your speech will bomb at the convention.
Nighttime is no time for a one or two symptom medicine you take during the day.
Room service, you have any NyQuil?
The corner drugstore? With Vicks NyQuil, the nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, stuffy head fever so you can rest medicine, the difference is night and day.
Dance an Irish Jig with Nancy Kerrigan as she fights to make the finals at the Riders Ladies Skating Championships. Next on the CBS Sports Show.
Welcome back to Indianapolis. Sean McDonough with Quinn Buckner. When we spoke with Rick Pitino this morning, he said maybe the loss to Massachusetts earlier in the week was a good thing because his team played such a tight game. They look so uptight against Massachusetts, and they're a much more relaxed-looking squad today.
Well, they are, but you have to remember, these kids for the entire summer and the beginning of the season were told they were the best thing since sliced bread, and Rick thought it was a good lesson for them, so they realized, yeah, you played a great game, but you still got beat.
Neil Reed with the ball for Indiana. He's a sophomore. Went to high school in the New Orleans area, but grew up in Indiana. Lindemann, the seven-footer. Double team. And the pass to Reed deflected by McCarty.
Anytime you allow Todd Lindemann to get the ball and he can't go right up and score with it, Kentucky's going to take advantage of that. See, they're forcing the ball to Todd Lindemann because they know that he's not accustomed to this kind of pressure.
Wilkerson and forced to stop as he looked to the basket with Robbie Eggers and a three-pointer driven in by Neil Reed.
And I think because Reed can not only do that, but he can control tempo, he's going to be a big factor in this game should Indiana get any kind of chance.
He was a big factor last year at 17 points against the Wildcats. 20-10 Kentucky. Just more than 6 minutes played here in the first half. Jeff Shepard into the game for UK, wearing number 15. And Ron Mercer has checked in, the most highly recruited high school senior last year, wearing number 33.
Oh, the shot clock is going down.
McCarty at the buzzer, missed a three.
And it goes over the back. But you're right, you were talking about Ron Mercer. Ron Mercer's the real deal. And we talked about the pressures. One of the things that Rick Pitino talked to us about was alleviating some of that on his freshman, Ron Mercer being one of those people. So he doesn't have to feel. He's played two tough games here early in the season, and he hadn't done as well as he'd like. You don't want to lose confidence in him.
Bouye Zinovich showing his ability to run the floor. Eggers a follow. He missed as he collided with Wayne Turner, who's checked in for Kentucky wearing number 5. McCarty behind the back. It didn't work. Wilkerson. McCarty controlled the rebound. It's still 20-10 Kentucky, 7 minutes play.
That's a bad shot because this is the way Kentucky wants to play.
Wayne Turner missed from just inside the foul line. Turner, another highly touted freshman. He's from Boston. Indiana just 3 of 12 from the floor. Evans makes it 4 for 13.
Well, that's why you don't want to get, Kentucky doesn't want Evans to get the ball because he can stick it, but this tempo is clearly in Kentucky's favor.
Ryan Evans has 7 of the 12 Indiana points. Neil Reed nearly had a steal. Turner knocks it in this time from just inside the free throw line.
are you tired yet looking at this?
Neil Reed looked tired as he dribbled past that double team. Out of bounds by the Kentucky bench. Rick Pitino livid. He thought there was a foul committed by Indiana before the ball went out of bounds.
Kentucky
clearly the ball went out on Kentucky.
Sorry, John. Kentucky always comes from the back. And if you're playing as a guard, you've got to know if you beat a Kentucky player, he will make an effort to get back into the play and poke the ball.
Eggers. Long with his shot. Bouye Zinovich gets the roll.
Indiana 14, this is the biggest team Bob Knight has really had that had some people that can move. And Harris is, I'm going to choose to call him, is the reason why, because he's so strong. And they just call a foul on Pope, trying to post up Harris.
Timeout, 11:48 remaining in the first half. Kentucky by 8.
Stood there boldly, sweating in the sun. Felt like a million, felt like number one, like a rock.
Chevy Astro,
like a rock.
The only truck tough enough to handle childhood.
Need a break?
Yeah!
Well, come on! The Monopoly game is bigger, better, and back at McDonald's. Just order any of these McDonald's food favorites to get your game piece. Win instantly, or collect and win. Cruises, Dodge Vipers, cash, $1 million.
Wow! Sega Saturn with the Daytona USA game.
With over 100 million new prizes, this is your best holiday break ever.
I won!
You won! Hang out right today.
Chet and I were looking for a high traffic zone, so we set up next to Gateway 2000. Heard they were selling over 1 million computers a year. It turns out they can give people more computer for their money because they sell them all over the phone.
Nice for computer buyers. A major setback for the souvenir industry.
Gateway computers feature the Intel Pentium processor. Call 1-800-GATEWAY for a free information kit on how to get more computer by buying factory direct.
Natural ability can only take you so far. Equipment counts for a lot. I'm always checking out new ideas. You have to stay competitive. That's what I like about Pert Plus. Cleans and conditions in one step. No messing with two bottles. I get great results. No hassle, no fuss. Eventually, we all cross the finish. The winners just find a better way to get there.
Pert Plus, great hair, no fuss.
Kentucky by 8, nearly midway through the first half. Indiana coming off a 19-12 season a year ago. Bob Knight did something he rarely does. He scouted the junior college ranks to bring in talent this year. Brought in 3 junior college players, but one of them, Lou Moore, has already left. It just didn't work out between Moore and Coach Knight. They had a amicable parting. Yesterday, Coach Knight called him no more.
He's no more, and he would have been significant because he was 6'7", he was athletic, and will give Indiana something they didn't have a lot of, as Jared Pickett just gets called for a foul.
Particularly in a game like this, Moore would have been helpful with his ability to run the court at 6'7". Prickett just into the game, wasted no time in collecting his first foul. We want to go back to the story involving Antoine Walker, although he was the player who slapped at the ball, and that resulted in the Kentucky technical. They charged the technical to the team and not to Walker, and therefore he has only one personal foul. Technicals do count against the player, but not in that instance. Deemed the officials. Wilkerson had a shot blocked, but there to follow it was Brian Evans, and he has nine.
Well, they've been forcing it. It's been interesting as the tempo's been up, but Indiana's still in this game.
Shepard had it blocked by Wilkerson.
You want to stay active when you're on the floor. One of the most active people on the floor was Brian Evans. He was on the other side of the lane and was able to get over and get that. That was bad block out on the part of Kentucky.
Derek Anderson, number 23.
And because of that, Derek Anderson comes back in the lineup for Mercer, Ron Mercer, for that very reason, so he can get Brian Evans, because Brian has scored like 6 points here without a lot of effort.
Epps and Shepard down the backcourt with Anderson, Walker, and Pickett, and there's a steal by Evans. Walker the defender, and a foul on the rebound action. Epps had the rebound, and Eggers bumped him from behind.
But good defensive effort on the part of Antoine Walker, who threw the pass away. Got back fast enough to make a difference on that. Brian Evans anticipating passes right here. Antoine Walker throws the pass, and then it's Antoine Walker that gets back. Now, he won't block the shot, but because he gets back, Brian Evans can't go up strong and therefore missed the shot. Kentucky's ball.
And a steal. Pass deflected to Evans. Coach Knight gesturing to Evans a moment ago after the misplay to keep your chin up, and he was applauding for the fine defensive play at the other end. And the pass. Wilkerson fortunate to get away with that one as it was knocked out of bounds by Anderson.
That's why he's in the game. Anderson is a much more aggressive defensive player, transferred from Ohio State, set out last year, and is obviously impacting the team more on the defensive side of the ball.
Neil Reed left it for Evans. Walker quickly out on him.
Too late. I'm telling you, this kid has got a funny looking game, but he can score. And once I saw him get Antoine Walker off his feet, there's nobody really that could defend him.
Evans is 4 out of 6 for 11 points, and Indiana has climbed back within 4. And a bad pass by Epps, picked off by Eggers. Indiana willing to run with the catch. Evans, 3!
Rick Pitino's calling timeout.
A 14-2 run for Indiana.
The revolution will be led by Jason Kidd, Jimmy Jackson, Eddie Jones, Joe Smith, and Kevin Garnett. But it will not be followed by post-game, up-close, and personal interviews, because the revolution will not be televised. The revolution will not be televised, and the revolution will not fail. For as it fulfills the unfulfilled promise of Hank Gathers and Ben Wilson, the revolution is about basketball, and basketball is the truth.
It was a 20-second timeout called by Kentucky. Each team gets 120 per half, and Indiana right back on the heels of the Cats.
Well, this is a very good play by Sharon Wilkerson, because he takes the defense inside. That's one of the strengths of Brian Evans, is his ability to shoot a three-point shot. And because Anderson collapsed, that left Evans open for that particular shot.
I hate to tell you this, Quinn, but Evans, 25th all-time leading scorer at IU, creeping up on number 24, a fellow named Butner.
Oh, no problem. He can get that.
Well, they need 65 today to catch you. I think you're safe at number 24 for at least one more game. Anderson got no rim with the shot, but Walker there to follow it up. 8 points for Antoine Walker. The Kentucky lead back to 3. Walker's 4 for 4 from the floor. Reed and Miller now the backcourt for IU. With Evans, Eggers, and Muye Zinovich up front. There's Harris. A lot of Indiana fans don't know what he looks like. He's been playing with a protective mask, a goalie's mask from hockey over his face. Walker, the dunk.
I tell you who's causing the problem for Indiana, and that's Anderson. Derek Anderson is way too quick for Brian Evans to guard. Evans is either going to get a foul or Kentucky gets a basket.
Nijazinovic had it blocked, but there's Eggers. Well, has this been fun or what?
I'm sitting here loving this.
We've only played a little more than 11 minutes. Kentucky by one, 26-25.
Kentucky is a team of spurts. They will score in spurts, but they'll let you score in spurts too.
Anderson, the miss, and a foul on Kentucky on the rebound action. Looked like it was on Jared Prickett. It is, and it's his second personal.
Going to the basket is one thing. You see, good defensive play, but coming back is Eggers. Just Indiana been, in the last 3 minutes, it looks like Indiana's been quicken to the ball. The emotion, it seems, to kind of fallen aside a little bit of Kentucky. But having all that talent we talked about, that's why Rick Pitino can get away with playing 10 players, because he's got a load of talent keeping the pressure on you.
The question is, can Indiana, which is not as deep a team, maintain this pace for the full 40 minutes? Eggers missed from in close. Of course, Massachusetts was relatively fresh at the end of the game, despite playing really only five players nearly the entire game. But Massachusetts didn't get into this up-and-down game. They, from time to time, had sustained half-court possession.
Yeah, I think that's the most important part. Massachusetts just never got up in a real up-and-down game. They would do it maybe two or three possessions, and then they would rightfully bring it back down the way they can handle it.
And Quinn, you get the feeling around the Commonwealth of Kentucky, anything less than a national championship would be considered a disappointment this year for Kentucky. And in this day and age of parity with so many good teams, that's really ridiculous, especially in a single elimination NCAA tournament. McCarty, another alley-oop for the dunk. The lead is three for the Wildcats.
Chris Rolls is coming into the game, and he's playing guard. He's never played against this kind of pressure, not with that kind of quickness.
Neil Reed banked it in. Chris Rolls wearing number four. Three guards on the floor at the moment for IU. Delp followed his own shot. Walker trapped in the corner by Nijazinovic. 7.5 left in the first half. Kentucky by one.
You're going to keep trying it. I'm going to call him Harris.
I think we found the rhythm with Harris's name. Walker.
I watched him this summer. That's Antoine Walker in the U.S. Festival, Olympic Festival. He did the exact same thing. He's really hard to guard because he's so quick for a guy that size, and he just picked up his third foul. Was that his second?
Second, because they didn't charge the technical to him personally. But it is a bonus situation now. That gets Kentucky to seven team fouls, and Indiana will shoot one and one until Kentucky has committed its 10th, and then it's a two-shot opportunity for Kentucky.
I think the most important question for Indiana is the one you asked just about 2 minutes ago. You can see in your screen there were two Indiana players, both of them, Harris and Eggers, pulling on their shorts already. I mean, they're tired. This is just a pace that's just hard to keep up with Kentucky, and then they can keep fresh legs on the floor.
Rolls missed the front end of the one and one. And a foul on the rebound action against Indiana. It's on Nijazinovic, much to the chagrin of Bob Knight in his 25th year as head coach at IU and his 31st season as a college head coach. Next Saturday, doubleheader action again here on CBS Sports. Begins with regional coverage at 1 Eastern time, UMass against BC. Some of you will see Cincinnati and Arkansas. And the entire nation will see Duke and Michigan at 3 Eastern time next Saturday.
Get a chance to see that Michigan team that has, they have three very good freshmen on that team. Robert Traylor is about 6'9", he's about 300 pounds, he can play. Mike Krzyzewski is back with Duke. Lewis Bullock is on Michigan. And Albert White, they've got three outstanding freshmen on that team.
Duke already with a win over Indiana in Alaska by 6. Rolls left it for Miller. It's Kentucky by 3, just under 7 minutes remaining in the first half.
Charlie Miller, I think, for Indiana to be successful the way they need to be this year, Miller is the one who was a big-time scorer in high school that's got to be the third scorer on the team.
Shot clock at 10. Eggers for three. Kentucky fans wanted a foul on the rebound action on Patterson as he came over the back.
I don't disagree with the rebound.
Nice pass by McCarty, and Mercer was fouled as he attempted the reverse layup. Andre Patterson fouled him his second. And that puts Indiana over the limit in five.
Well, you got a team in Kentucky that they're very unselfish, and Rick Pitino says sometimes too unselfish. You see Walter McCarty make the good pass, and then Mercer does a good job of coming to the side, and Andre Patterson not able to get up in time. But this is a young man that knows how to play the game both ends, can score, can defend. But he's like most freshmen that come into college basketball. Playing against this kind of competition is just not something he's done before. And it'll take him maybe another year or two before he's able to show everything he's capable of doing.
Mercer, the National High School Player of the Year last year at Oak Hill Academy in Virginia.
Timeout.
Timeout. Kentucky leads by four.
Here comes one. Oh, an 87 Buick station wagon.
Got it.
74 Volkswagen Beetle. A 285 horsepower V8 6-speed 1996 Chevy Camaro. Z28.
Yeah, but what color?
Touch the future at Radio Shack. Touch Total Image Video. Aptiva from IBM. Touch Theater Sound. Touch a complete multimedia experience. The IBM Aptiva has it all and more. Touch it for yourself at Radio Shack. And with special credit terms, we'll not only help you touch the future, we'll help you own it. Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers.
No one knows how to reverse the aging process. But we do know that proper nutrition is one of the keys to staying healthy and active. Unfortunately, sometimes we're just too busy to eat right. The good news is, now there's Boost. It's a whole new kind of milkshake with 25 important vitamins and minerals, including antioxidants and beta carotene. No, there isn't a fountain of youth, but you can help keep your body at its best with Boost.
An old play, you gotta be aware of where the ball is at all times. You watch right here in the pass, and now watch. This head turned, and then there's the back screen coming right there. Defense doesn't help right here, but that's the patience Kentucky has. They know they have people that can go up and get it, and you can see McCarty go up and get that one because the defense didn't help out. Great execution on the part of Kentucky.
For those of you just joining us, Kentucky jumped off to a quick 14-point lead. Brian Evans has brought Indiana back. He has 14 points. Antoine Walker perfect from the floor. He has 12. And Kentucky shooting very well, but their lead is only four, and Indiana will play it in.
Indiana was able to get to the pace that I didn't think they could play to, and I'm not sure they can stay with, and was able to get themselves back in this game. But as I said, Kentucky scores in spurts, but teams that do that will let you score in spurts as well.
Well, Kansas, number two at the start of the week, with the comfort behind winning the first half of our doubleheader. That's a 10-second call. Wilkerson didn't get across the timeline in time. Given that Kansas won today, they number one next week, do you figure?
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it. I mean, they're a very good basketball team. They were down 15 to a very talented UCLA team and got their composure and come back to win by 15. I think you have to give them the nod for number one.
Cricket. Off a nice feed from McCarty. And Massachusetts will probably move up from five, given their wins this week over Kentucky and Maryland, two top 20 teams. Kentucky ranked number one at the time of the Massachusetts win.
This is a bad place to get trapped because you have this sideline right here in that corner. It's a bad place to get trapped, but any guard should know better than that. The one place, young players, you don't want to come to this corner because you use the half-court line, and then you'll see the sideline becomes an additional defender. Keep yourself in the middle of the court when you're playing against trapping teams.
Evans passed up a three. Patterson kicked it out. Wilkerson. And the ball got tipped to Miller for the easy two.
Tony Delk was trying to get it. He was Miller's man and just bounced off his hand.
Oh, Wilkerson missed the outside shot. That was a problem for Indiana last year. Their guards cannot knock in the jumpers consistently enough.
It's a problem they have this year. They will struggle because the best shooter they have is Brian Evans, who's their forward.
Turner, good pass. Mercer, that's freshman to freshman for two for Kentucky. Rick Pitino said this morning he thinks Turner will be their starting point guard before the year is over.
That's travel.
Foul called first. Foul? Mercer apparently hit Miller in the forehead. The gesture given by the official John Clogarty.
Kentucky is a team, and well, you talked about Wayne Turner is the guard of the future. Don't question the point guard of the future. He can create his own shots, but here he creates one for Ron Mercer. What Mercer can really do is he can explode to the basket. What Turner does extremely well is he can not only get you a shot, but he can get himself a shot. Rick Pitino said this is the best one-on-one player we have on the team.
And Miller made the first free throw. Charlie coming off a career-best 7 assists in Indiana's last game, a 20-point win over Notre Dame. Hoosiers opened in Alaska with a win over Alaska Anchorage, then lost two games in Alaska to Duke and Connecticut. They were blown out by the UConn Huskies by 34 points, then bounced back at home with the win over Notre Dame. Neil Reed in for Miller. And the Kentucky lead is 4 points with 4:50 left in the half. Pickett.
You see all the things that Kentucky can do. One of the things they normally do is turn you over a lot. Indiana has just 5 turnovers. Kentucky forces 23 a game. That's one of the reasons Indiana's still in this game. Kentucky himself only have 6 turnovers.
Evans was fouled in the backcourt as he tried to break free from the double team.
Personal foul, Kentucky, number 5, Wayne Turner.
Fouls on Turner, his second.
The team's ninth.
Rick Pitino, 43 years old in his 7th season at Kentucky. Near the conclusion of today's game, we'll select a genuine Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game from each team. To date, Chevrolet has contributed nearly $5.5 million to the scholarship funds of America's colleges and universities. Evans, it rattles out. Cardi got away with a shove as he pushed
the huge shove. Great catch. I'm telling you, that is some kind of catch because that ball was out of bounds. McCarty threw it to the wrong side of Mercer, and he was able to control it and get it down.
Well, Kentucky's up to 65% from the floor for the half, and a big reason why they're getting such easy shots, dunks and layups. Evans for 3.
From the time that play set up, Evans went over to that three-point line and just stood to wait on that shot.
Evans has half of the Indiana points, 17 of the 34. Cricket, an air ball from 3. And Indiana will play it in trailing by 5 with 4 minutes left in the first half. And a timeout here at the RCA Dome in Indianapolis.
Scary place. The Chevy Blazer with the exclusive driver control system. It's nice to know it's there. Denim in every pair of Levi's jeans.
So what's it going to be, Dion? Football or baseball?
Both, boss.
Both?
Both.
Offense or defense?
Both.
Both?
Both.
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 Pizza Hut.
Meat lovers or stuffed crust pizza?
Both.
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 Want it all? Now Pizza Hut offers our Lover's Line toppings. Meat lovers, pepperoni lovers, or supreme. Piled high in a stuffed crust pizza.
So what'll it be, Dion? 15, 20 million?
Both.
Both. You'll love the stuff we're made of.
4th and inches. Coach Bannon, he likes to punt.
Huh?
No way.
Whoa!
Check this out.
Attention, Coach Bannon. Go for it. Be a man.
Oh, what do you know, Steve? They're going to go for it. Just a reminder, when you've got the great taste of an ice-cold Miller Lite, life is good.
Do you like my new hat?
Kozak drops back to pass.
Jones is open in the end zone.
Throws it to Jones to drop the ball.
Bad call.
Jill Bunnin.
Yep.
Sean McDonough, Quinn Buckner back at the RCA Dome in downtown Indianapolis, Indiana. 4 minutes to go till halftime. Kentucky by five. And coming up at the half, Pat O'Brien with scores and highlights early in the season, but already a very interesting Saturday in college basketball with the defending national champs, UCLA, going up against Kansas. UMass battling Maryland.
Well, I don't know about you. I'm a basketball junkie, so it's been great. This
They're all interesting.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you got interesting games every Saturday and Sunday for sure. But the lineups have been outstanding.
Turner missed from in close. Indiana with the ball, trailing by five. Turner with the steal. Wilkerson didn't see him coming. This is 2-on-0.
He traveled.
He did.
Yeah, he traveled.
Derek Anderson traveled. Bobby Knight in the face of Andre Patterson, telling him to get the ball up the floor. We could read his lips from over there. I think we could hear him from here.
Well, I just want to see, does he take a step? Yeah, they're saying when he caught the ball, he had both feet on the ground. And he's not allowed to put him down on the ground again, both feet, and then take the shot. One from a two-foot stop, he can go up, but not the way he did.
Good pass. Oh! The dunk after the feed by Wilkerson. Bob Knight yesterday singing the praises of his center duo, Uye Zinovich and Lindemann. They've combined to average about 18 points and 10 rebounds a game. That's good play from the center position. Good call by Quinn. Dr. Quinn, basketball man, as Prickett was in the lane too long.
But you were on the point. It was about the center play, and that's why I happen to be paying a little bit more attention to it, because on the inside, they've been getting like 18 points defensively. That's 5 seconds. He's too late. But they give him the timeout.
Oh, they did.
Boy, that's that new man. I thought that was...
Well, John Clarkley was shaking his head no, as if to say to Patterson, you didn't call the timeout quickly enough. You can see that Bob Knight wants a 20, so we will stay here.
Yeah, they're trying to get in. He's after Sharon Wilkerson, who is their point, who is the guard. Now, between he and Neil Reed, they have got to go get the basketball. But let's give Kentucky some credit here, too. They did a good job of shutting off the passing angles, and that's the reason that the 22nd timeout had to be called. I mean, you look, Kentucky is manned. Everybody is covered. They got McCarty on the ball. And you can't throw it to Todd Lindemann in the corner, because you don't want a center standing down there trying to handle the ball. That's why the 22nd timeout had to come back, had to come.
And Lindemann does not have good hands. That's been a criticism of him from Hoosier fans over the years, although he's worked hard to correct that part of his game.
And he's not very good at catch and dribbling the ball. Oh, no! Oh, no, he didn't do that.
Well, perhaps Coach Knight's pep talk helped Andre Patterson. He went to the bucket with some authority.
That was about as aggressive as I think I've ever seen him do it.
McCarty quiets the red-clad Hoosier fans, and the Kentucky lead is back to three with 2:37 left in the half. Wilkerson already with five assists. Now Reed, the son of a coach, his dad Terry Reed, assistant coach at Iowa State. Evans, a couple of fakes, forced it up and got it to go, and he has 19. Maybe he'll get the 65 to catch Quinn Buckner on the all-time scoring list today.
I'm just enjoying the basketball. Kentucky goes after a great dunk that could have gotten the crowd involved, come back and get an easy basket, and Indiana makes up, and then another good play by Kentucky.
Well, Bob Knight, this has to be driving him nuts. You know that he does not like it when his defense gives up layup after layup, as they have here in the first half.
Because that's really what sets the tempo for Indiana more than anything else, is their defense. And that hadn't, and Kentucky's taking advantage of Indiana's lack of defense.
Patterson, couple of kicks, and got the bounce. 43-42, Kentucky. Prickett.
Oh.
Goaltending.
And it was such a bad decision. If you're standing under the basket, you don't try to block a shot. I mean, Prickett makes a tough move, no doubt about it, but I don't think he had much chance to get it in. But there's no doubt, Andre Patterson is standing under the basket. You don't try to block a shot from there.
Again, trouble getting it in, and they inbound it to a tough spot in the corner. Wilkerson had trouble on the handle. They need to hurry to get it over, and Reed did. Then went flying through the air. Anderson couldn't save it.
Well, you wonder about the tempo because it will go Kentucky way. They'll explode to the basket as Andre Patterson did there. But Kentucky will come back at you on the other end. But Indiana keeping themselves at a faster pace, and I think they'd like to play.
And they're happy to see that from Patterson. Last year, Indiana observers felt that he was a little too tentative, almost too nice a guy on the court. And he even said he needs to demonstrate more toughness on the court. Lindemann called for a push-off as he tried to accept that pass. First foul on Todd Lindemann, the 7-foot senior from Channing, Michigan.
Personal foul, Indiana, number 50, Todd Lindemann.
Frankly, for Bob Knight, I think he's got to be halfway pleased that Lindemann showed that kind of aggressiveness. He's another young man that hadn't been very aggressive.
I'm a little bit surprised that Indiana, obviously, Quinn, said we're going to come out here and try to run with Kentucky because we heard your conversation with Coach Knight at the half of the first game. He talked about the joy of coaching in this day and age for him is systems, and can your system beat their system? Well, he's not really using his system today to try to beat Kentucky. It looks like he's trying to beat them at their own game.
Well, I think what he's doing is just trying to see can his team stay under control. They pretty much have gotten this thing going the way Kentucky wants it to go. From there, the players have got to simmer down. I don't think they can really slow it down, frankly, because Kentucky won't let them.
Under a minute left in the half. A three-pointer would tie it for IU. Ten on the shot clock. Five to shoot.
You'll make a play out of this.
Forces one up. And Lindemann tipped it in.
And the shot clock was down to one, and then Lindemann tipped it in.
And Kentucky can hold for the final shot of the half.
There's some quickness out here. I mean, Epson's got a very good chance to get by Reed.
Epps fouled. It wouldn't go. Lindemann committed the foul. His second.
Indiana has go-to people. Brian Evans is that go-to man, but the shot is taken. You can see number 50 in your screen go up, able to get a hand on it and tip it in. I wasn't sure if that one was actually off the rim. But Todd Lindemann getting some inside play. That two-headed monster you talked about is averaging about 10 points between he and Harris, if you will. So they've been able to get some production, or a lot more than they have in the past, from that center position.
Anthony Epps makes the first. And the Kentucky lead is two. Kentucky never led at any point in the game earlier this week against UMass, and they have never trailed in the first half this afternoon against Indiana. Time for a last-second attempt for IU. Reed, a launch at the buzzer. Woo! Right on line, and it clanged off the front rim. Most entertaining first half between these two longtime rivals, and at the break, it's Kentucky by three.
Like a
six World Series, six basketball seasons, six hockey playoffs, six football seasons, and just one tune-up after 100,000 miles. Vortec engines, one more reason to drive a Chevy truck.
Like a
Chevy trucks.
Many know the University of Kentucky only by its sports teams, but we have much more on the ball. A first-class research university, we're also ranked nationally for pharmacy, medicine, and business. And our students go on to become famous astronauts, distinguished Nobel Prize winners, best-selling authors, and even actresses. Sports are only a part of the University of Kentucky. Get to know it all.
The challenge? Combine quality intercollegiate athletics with academic standards of the highest order. For more than 60 years, these fundamentals have fostered a tradition rich with championship performances, scholastic excellence, and legendary leaders. Today, the SEC remains dedicated to the same ideals. For a commitment to excellence endures the test of time.
Coming up on Pennzoil at the Half, we'll have all the scores and highlights after a message and this word from your very own local station.
In racing, there's no margin for error. The crew follows the same procedures every time the car pulls into the pits. It's the same way at Jiffy Lube. We follow the same strict procedures more than 50,000 times a day. It's your assurance that when you bring your car to Jiffy Lube, the job will be done right.
And Jiffy Lube offers Pennzoil.
Jiffy Lube, the world's most experienced oil changers. That's why if it doesn't say Jiffy Lube, it just isn't Jiffy Lube.
College football, the fanfare, the fight, the fun, and the frenzy that builds with the bowl season. On CBS, the festivities heat up with the Sun Bowl. On New Year's Day, the celebration begins with the Cotton Bowl. Then college football's future, where the Bowl Alliance choices for number 3 and number 5 meet in the FedEx Orange Bowl. On January 2nd, the great games continue with the ultimate, the battle for the national championship, the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. It's college football's big one. Just watch.
Here on CBS.
Hey,
heads.
We would like to elucidate.
I tell you about how.
You're way ahead with the Midas three-way guarantee. Firstly, we'll meet or beat the other guy's written estimates on breaker exhaust repair.
Can we do that?
Of course we can.
Secondly,
the estimate you approve is the price you pay. Surprise!
No surprises.
And finally,
we guarantee the famous Midas muffler and all brake shoes and pads.
For as long as you own your car.
So come to Midas.
And get the Midas three-way guarantee.
That's the Midas way.
The way it should be.
You better believe it.
To save the most money on furniture, you gotta drive to the Furniture Factory Outlets in North Carolina. To save on carpeting, you drive to Georgia. But where do you go for discount outlet prices on a new car? Drive no farther than Southern Indiana to John Jones GM City in Salem or Corydon. Only John Jones offers a complete line of new surplus General Motors cars, trucks, and vans at discount outlet prices. So if you want factory outlet savings on a new car, don't drive all over the place. Just come to John Jones GM City in Salem and Corydon.
Kingfish Restaurants proudly presents Shrimp as You Like It. Cool, delectable shrimp cocktail served up with our special tangy sauce. A feast of golden fried shrimp, alone or combined with plump cocktail shrimp. Or as a delicious variation on a theme, a duet of crisp fried shrimp and tender whitefish. Or shrimp and delicate pan-fried oysters in perfect harmony. Shrimp as You Like It, fixed especially for you at Kingfish Restaurants.
I'm Steve Bergen, and an ultralight aircraft crashes near Springfield, Kentucky. The story at 6.
CBS Sports presents Pennzoil at the Half, sponsored by Pennzoil. For more engine miles, Pennzoil works like liquid ball bearings.
Makes you want to smile, doesn't it? They're ringing in the holidays. We're also ringing in the college basketball season. And hello, Santa. And hi again, everybody. I'm Pat O'Brien, and welcome to our second edition of Pennzoil at the Half. Kentucky 47, Indiana 44. Antoine Walker leads Kentucky with 12 points. Let's fire up the scoreboard. Earlier today, Kansas beat UCLA. 85-70 was the final. UCLA now the first defending national champion since Louisville in 86 to begin their defending campaign at 2-3. Early on, though, they were strong. Look at Jelani McCoy go inside off the glass for two there. But Kansas fought back. Jock Vaughn dishes out. Oh, a sweet alley-oop pass to Paul Pierce. And he puts it in for the deuce. Now Vaughn strikes again. Kansas take the lead. Jock Vaughn, unbelievable spinorama. Kansas, well, they turned it around by switching to a zone and just stifled UCLA.
Well, we were looking for something to help us because we weren't doing a good job defensively in the man. We probably worked on a zone 10 possessions the whole year, and that's it in practice. Haven't played in a single possession in any game until today, but you search for things, and luckily we found some.
That's what you do if you're a player. You stand there and nod while your coach talks. Kansas wins 85-70. How about this game? Massachusetts was down 13. They come back to beat Maryland 50-47. John Calipari coming off his win over top-ranked Kentucky. takes on the Terps, and they went up 11. The Terps did on a nice alley-oop pass from Dwayne Simpkins to Keith Booth. Boom! He puts it in. The UMass battle back is Dante Bright. Scores on a little give and go. Nice dish from the big man, Marcus Camby, who's making a statement early on in the season. Then Carmelo Travieso. Love that name, Carmelo Travieso. Nice D! Edgar Padilla nails the J on the other end, just stops and puts it in. Stops on a dime. And then Marcus Camby again finishes off Maryland. A nice little jumper here. And as we said, Marcus is out for a statement this year. And Massachusetts goes on to win at 50-47. Great comeback for them. Also in college basketball, a little later today, Georgetown and West Virginia. Chicago State and Missouri, the number 13 team, up 44-20 early on in the first half. Georgia Tech and Appalachian State, 89-65, another mismatch. Why is Appalachian State playing Georgia Tech? Because Bobby Kremins used to be the head coach at Appalachian State. So it'd be kind of nice to have him on the schedule. Not a good idea for Appalachian State. Matt Harpring scores three of his early 17 to give the Yellow Jackets a 44-17 halftime lead. Second half, Tech continued to dominate. Stephon Marbury takes a full court bounce pass from Drew Berry, puts it in, and then John Kelly feeds Berry for a reverse dunk. And Drew is hacked in the act, and Georgia Tech wins that one 89-65. And we'll have more scores and highlights as At the Half rolls on. Stay with us.
Recently, the Broncos and 49ers showcased their talents in Tokyo.
Love is a many splendored thing.
At Zone West
Stand
Karaoke.
By your man.
Blame it on the bossa nova. The dance of love.
Where the players brought no ability to carry a tune, but did bring their Visa card.
Was it the moon?
Because Zone West can accept just about anything except American Express.
Everybody sing. It's the April Rose that only.
Hey, you'll get a charge out of this. We're watching college hoops, okay? The fans are totally energized. The teams come out amped up like a heavyweight title bout in Vegas, and suddenly, this light bulb goes on over our heads. You know what would look cool on these guys? Well, unless the college teams got totally turned on by their look. So, boom, that's what they're wearing this year. Now let me flash something else by you, okay? All that stuff? Converse, Converse, Converse. I know what you're thinking, man. Converse? Whoa, I'm shocked.
We have seen a new beginning in higher education, a new public university, creating a higher standard for learning and giving people the skills to compete in the world economy, a true partner in the future of Indiana and America. For 175 years, we have grown to become that university. We are America's new public university.
Allison, my ring.
Grandma's ring.
We're never gonna find it.
We can find it. Is that it?
No, I've looked there.
You can look and look, but you never know where you're gonna find a dream fulfilled.
Let's pretend we're playing hide and seek. Come on, it'll be fun.
Yet the universities of the Big Ten are celebrating 100 years of just that.
This is stupid. We're never going to find it. Let's go.
When you support higher education, you'll help kids' dreams come alive for the next 100 years.
Hey, leaving without this?
No way. You found it.
You can find anything if you look hard enough.
This message furnished by the universities of the Big Ten.
I think college basketball is popular in Indiana. Look at that crowd there. They trail Kentucky, the number one team, only by three, 47-44 at the half. Following basketball on the show, we'll continue our coverage of the Riders Ladies Skating Championship, where you'll see some of the finest skaters in the world.
We'll be right back.
fun. Also, we'll talk live with University of Miami football coach Butch Davis about the off-the-field troubles that the Hurricanes are having. That's all on the show next, right after basketball. And tomorrow, of course, we're back to the gridiron with a CBS Sports exclusive. The announcement of the Fiesta Orange and Sugar Bowl pairings at 5:30 Eastern Time on the Great Games Selection Show. Great games today. Let's go back to the scoreboard. Party at West Point. Army beats Navy 14-13, the final there. And here's our men in uniform. There's our men in uniform. Navy got out to an early lead as quarterback Ben Fay hits LeBron Butts for 22 yards. Touchdown pass. And Navy celebrates. In the fourth quarter, Navy tries to finish Army up by going for a touchdown instead of a field goal, but defense denied. Less than 2 minutes left, fourth and 24, Army converts as Ronnie Makeda finds John Graves for 27 yards and a first down. And then just two plays later, folks, you guessed it, John Conroy goes in for Army, finishes Navy off. Party at West Point. Army beats Navy 14-13. Virginia Tech and William & Mary, 71-66 was the final there. Notre Dame and Rutgers, the first Big East matchup for them, 86-80 was the outcome there at Rutgers in overtime. And Georgia and Pittsburgh, 85-86, the final there. And Temple and Wisconsin, 57-54 in overtime, Wisconsin. We'll join Sean McDonough and Quinn Buckner for the second half of Kentucky, Indiana, after a message and a word from your local station. Enjoy the second half, folks.
Pennzoil at the Half was sponsored by Pennzoil. For more engine miles, Pennzoil works like liquid ball bearings.
Jackson, one night only. You've never been this close. Only on HBO.
You know, these Tostitos are baked.
Get out of here.
Really?
But so tasty.
Oh, I had this party, and I told everyone that baked Tostitos are low in fat, but nobody believed me.
Wow.
Baked Tostitos have only 1 gram of fat per serving, but they don't taste it.
These are baked?
Mm-hmm.
Get out of here.
Oh, yeah.
Get out of here.
Get out of here.
Really? They're baked?
No, really.
Get out of here.
Baked Tostitos, tortilla chips, and fat-free salsa. You got Tostitos, you got a party.
He faced down an American president and turned back an American troop ship. And all the while, he was working for the CIA. And he brags about it. Sunday on 60 Minutes.
You're on.
Spaghetti and meat sauce, real Italian lasagna, and fettuccine Alfredo. Sample a Fazoli sampler platter and have it all. And all the breadsticks you want are free when you dine in.
Fazoli's real Italian.
New personalized checking card has your face and signature right up front. It's head and shoulders above the rest.
I'm Steve Berry. There's a chance for rain in the forecast. Details at 6.
Welcome back to the RCA Dome in Indianapolis. Halftime, number one Kentucky. At least number one for a few more hours. Has a three-point lead over Indiana. Sean McDonough with Quinn Buckner. Quinn, that score that we saw and the tempo that we saw throughout the first half clearly would favor the type of game that Kentucky wants this to be, but Indiana's hanging right in there.
Well, they really have. And, Sean, what they've been able to do, they only have about 8 turnovers for Indiana, and Kentucky forces 23 a game. So, obviously, Indiana's been able to get enough shots, and the real key is that there haven't been a lot of points over. But Brian Evans has played outstanding basketball. He's been able to get the ball in position to make plays, And right here, Antoine Walker goes down, and once he had him beat, Brian Evans can really shoot the basketball. He's really been the story. He has 19 points in the first half on 7-10 shooting, and that's been really important for Indiana, getting Brian Evans off, and the rest of the team can feed off of him.
Indiana at 50% as a team, but Kentucky at 65%. They haven't bothered to go to their usual weapon, the three-point field goal, very often because they've been getting so many dunks and layups, and I'd imagine that was one of the things that Coach Knight talked about at halftime, how to stop Kentucky from getting so many easy buckets underneath.
Well, you got to know that Kentucky is going to run the ball back at you, and I think the defensive transition late in the first half was better for Indiana. I thought Kentucky rightfully took advantage of it early in the first half.
Indiana has not led in the game. They have the ball to open the second half. Evans short with it, and rebound by Epps. It's Epps and Delk.
Oh.
And now it's Walker to drop it in.
Not only was it a heck of a pass, but the layup was difficult because you got a 6'9 running under the basket. Antoine Walker controlled it and got it in.
In our first game this afternoon, Billy Packer made the point about Kansas. They're always looking to hit ahead because they have so many players who can run the floor and catch the ball and transition and handle it. And the same is true of Kentucky. You can throw it ahead to just about anybody on this team, and he'll be able to handle it on the move.
The ability to be able to make plays off the run once you catch the ball is what Kentucky's good at. They're starting off just as they did the first half.
Anderson went slashing to the goal for two. He has six. And Indiana will play it in again as Reed was upended in the corner by Anderson. Kentucky with 4 points unanswered to open the second half.
They'll get points because they'll get out and run, as you see Antoine Walker get out and run and just lay it gently over the rim.
Evans in the front court with Patterson, Mujezinovic for Indiana, Wilkerson and Reed, the backcourt for the Hoosiers.
They made the change. Charlotte Miller started the game, but they've got Neil Reed in because that's a little bit better control than us. That's why there was only 8 turnovers in the first half.
Evans has missed his first 2 attempts here in the second half. Looked like Mujezinovic got away with a push on the rebound action.
Very Walker. Good ball movement.
And Patterson the rebound. That's the first thing that Walker has done wrong today. Held ball.
That play exemplifies what Andre Patterson does not do the way he should. You got to snatch that ball through there. You can't go in there. The rebound is a good, tough rebound. Now you take it. Now when you go through, you pull it through when you go back the other way because you know their hand's there, and that's how Epps gets his hand on the ball. Kentucky gets it by the arrow.
And Delk missed a short one, but kept it alive for Anderson. Anderson went right by Evans.
Oh.
And McCarty missed the dunk, contested by Patterson. Reed went by McCarty and then got hit hard by McCarty.
Well, he had a shot on 2 different occasions. McCarty fouled Reed on that one, but he had a shot as soon as he caught it. He could have taken it. He ball faked and went by. Unfortunately for Indiana, there was a foul called there.
His first personal, the team's first this half.
2 shots.
Earlier today on CBS, Kansas came from behind to beat UCLA. Massachusetts a winner over Maryland. UMass another big game this week in Amherst against Wake Forest. Tim Duncan and Marcus Camby will be going head-to-head.
I mean, we'll be the two outstanding centers, probably as good as any centers in the country, going against each other. UMass obviously has, I think, a pretty good position because their guards are very solid. Trevor Ezeal and Padilla are very solid guards. They can make outside shots, and that's critical for the team in that center.
The guards of UMass considered a question mark when the season began. Many of you will see the UMass Minutemen next Saturday at 1 o'clock against Boston College. There's a travel called against Anderson as he took the pass, slashing across the foul line.
I tell you what, I'm sitting here watching this, and for the last 3 times, I've seen Andre Patterson have passes that he can make, and he won't pull the trigger.
And Wilkerson lost the handle. Indiana has been abysmal out of the locker room to start the second half. They're down by 6, 17-47 remain.
And that's one thing that Bob Knight has to be worried about. If the guy's open, he's got to pull the trigger. I don't know if he's scared or what, but if there was a long pass, he just wouldn't make.
Indiana's 0-for-3 from the floor in this half, and they've turned it over twice. The only point on a free throw. Walker 6-for-6 in the first half. was fouled that time by Patterson.
You know, Kentucky's been a little more patient with their offense this half. And I think that's made a difference because they almost to a man can beat Indiana off the dribble. So now Andre Patterson picked up that foul because Antoine Walker just beat him off the dribble.
Three fouls now on Patterson, so he leaves and Charlie Miller checks in. And Antoine Walker goes to the free throw line. He was voted to the preseason All-SEC team, first team selection. Coming off the outstanding performance in the SEC tournament last year, he was the tournament MVP. Tomorrow, the college football championship puzzle falls into place. The Bowl Alliance matchups will be announced during the Great Games Selection Show, 5:30 Eastern Time. Our coverage on CBS tomorrow, brought to you by Tostitos. Reed in big trouble, managed to get it off the leg of Walker.
But what you got to keep in mind, he's got to get the ball over at half court. There's only 30 seconds.
They have five to get it over the midcourt line. Apparently a hometown
great steal.
Second clock operator there.
That's intentional. Got to be intentional.
Wilkerson.
Good call.
Grabbed Walker around the head, and the intentional foul called.
Yeah, there's no question about it. Bob Knight is up asking what the hell is it for. He made no attempt to get to the basketball unless he just – he made no attempt to get to the basketball. That's a good call. I mean, first of all, the steal, Antoine Walker was standing back like he wasn't going to do anything. You've got to make an attempt for the ball, and he never made an attempt for the ball. He pulled him right across the shoulder so they'd get two shots and the ball out of bounds on the sideline. That's a good call.
Walker having his best game of the young season. 17 points on 7 of 8 from the floor and 3 out of 3 from the line.
He's a young man. There's Antoine Walker from Mount Carmel. Plays with great confidence in himself. Every now and then you see a little bit of emotion, but when he's got the ball, he looks like he knows exactly what he wants to do with it, and that makes a difference when you're playing against people who are scared of him.
Second half beginning as the first did. Walker traveled. Kentucky got off to a quick 9-2 lead in the first half, pushed their lead up to 14 before IU mounted the comeback. Now it's Kentucky by 10, nearly 3 minutes played in the second half.
That's the pass I've been talking about. Oh, no, the dribble killed him. The dribble killed him.
But Mujezinovic stayed with it. Was fouled. No,
foul.
Offensive foul. He charged into Anderson. What a dreadful possession for Indiana.
The dribble killed him on the first play. He had it. You can break the press a lot of ways. Sometimes you may want to dribble it across the press, or sometimes you can throw it out of here. If he just takes this and catches it in stride, once he takes the dribble, you see that extra step, and Antoine Walker is able to get there and not allow that easy basket. And you can see that's the foul, offensive foul. No question about the position.
Indiana 0-for-4 from the floor this half, and they turned it over 4 times. Kentucky by 10, 16:45 left. Walker passed it off to Pope. 3 seconds, the call.
And here's what Kentucky has decided to do. They're not only more patient, they've decided to go down inside with the basketball and force Indiana's big people to have to guard them and down on the block. And that's not something Indiana can do very well.
Timeout, Indiana. I would assume they'd want this to be a 20, and they do. To reiterate now, in every game this year, the teams be allowed one 20-second timeout per half. And Knight spending most of this timeout in the face of Harris Mujezinovic, who moved to this country in 1987. His family lived in Sarajevo prior to 1987. His father realized what was happening in their native land and brought the family to Chicago in 87.
That conversation, or basically what happened to Harris and still happening to him, is about him on the defensive end. As I started to talk about the inside play, Harris was one guy that was really being posted low, and Bob Knight is obviously very disappointed with that.
And again, they struggle to get it inbounds. Richard Mandeville is checked in wearing number 21 for Indiana. That was very nearly a travel on Reed. Miller. That's a two-pointer just in, no, a three. The officials looked at each other and then signaled three-point field goal.
Yeah, and John McCarthy just ran down again to signal it was a three-point shot. It was a bad shot, by the way, because he had just gotten it quick off the offense and just decided to put it up.
Foul on the drive.
You push it up on the break. If you got an opportunity, there's just no doubt about it. He's a good foot behind the line. And the officials conferred and again came up with the right answer.
And the foul was on Brian Evans, his third. And the fourth already against Indiana here in the second half. Kentucky's only been whistled for one. It's Kentucky by seven, nearly 4 minutes into the second half. Jones got the leaner to go. Only five for Delk. He had scored 21 in each of the first two games against Maryland and UMass. Miller was fouled while dribbling across the midcourt line.
The player that they just have not been able to handle, and I think played so much better here, is Antoine Walker.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he's gotten position where he needed to get it, and he's the reason that Kentucky right now is looking at a 9-point lead.
Foul on Pope was his third.
In searching for a luxury performance sedan, Michael Young tested the Oldsmobile LSS against three of the fastest Japan has to offer. The Infiniti J30, Lexus ES300, and Teppanyaki chef Yasu Norimoto. And while his 240 horsepower LSS was no match for Yasu's speed, not only did Mr. Young fare much better against the imports, he had them for lunch. Will the LSS pass your test?
What I do best. I take scores. You do what you do best, trying to stop guys like me.
Between a relentless cop.
All I am is what I'm going after.
A ruthless thief.
I'm the worst trouble you ever had.
And his reckless partner.
The bank is worth the risk.
Obsession knows no limits.
You are going down.
Al Pacino, Robert De Niro, Val Kilmer. Heat, rated R. Starts Friday, December 15th at a theater near you.
If your battery is more than 3 years old, you can wait till it dies, pay for a tow, and some new battery you never heard of. Or you can get to Sears now and get the Die Hard battery, America's most trusted for over 25 years, starting as low as $59.99. So before yours dies, get dependability. Get the Die Hard at Sears Auto Center.
Coaching college basketball, I'm always out there recruiting. And I need to be reachable anywhere or I'll lose the kids to another program. So I got my own AT&T 500 number that can reach me at virtually any phone.
Nixon.
There's this kid you gotta see. Donald Austin in Brookville.
It's called AT&T True Connections. And what it means is that I'm never out of touch.
Nixon.
Oh, hi, Mrs. Austin. Now the kids can be sure to get to me before they make their decision. My own 500 number sure helps.
That's your true choice, AT&T.
CBS brings the official word. The Bowl Alliance announces their selections and the teams battling for the national championship. The Great Game Selection Show, Sunday on CBS.
Kentucky led by three at the half. They now lead by nine and foul trouble for Indiana. Three starters with three fouls apiece. We talked about the depth advantage for Kentucky. Indiana can't afford to have anybody on the bench for a considerable length of time with foul difficulty. Wilkerson wide open just inside the free throw line. Teron Wilkerson with the easy two.
They opened up the defense and set some cross screens and were able to get Teron Wilkerson right across the top.
The first bucket for Wilkerson is now one of six from the floor.
Kentucky doing very much the same thing. They're keeping Antoine Walker inside and they're eventually going to try to get him the ball.
McCarty fouled. It was either foul McCarty or give him the uncontested two. So Miller wisely decided to foul him.
Well, you got to be active if you're playing. And there was a nice pick there. And Charlie Miller did the only thing he could do with Walter McCarty, keep him from getting that ball to go down. But McCarty was set up very well. Again, patience on the part of Kentucky leads to two foul shots.
And Walter made the first. Walter playing in his home state. He's a senior from Evansville, Indiana, a couple of years ago, 93, when this game was played in Louisville, he sang the national anthem. prior to the game.
Yeah, he also went to the same high school that former Indiana great did Calvert Cheney, along with the Washington Bullets.
Reed for three from well behind the line. His second three-pointer of the game. He has 9 points, and it's back to a six-point lead for Kentucky. Epps. Rebound hit the floor and is gobbled up by Mandeville. Reed looks to push.
I didn't think he had a chance to get there, and I'm looking for him the entire time to push the ball. You got to remember, this kid last year had a separated shoulder, didn't he, old Reed? And he's a very tough kid, and he's got Tony Dell, he's got him backing up, which is the way you want to do any defensive player. But he goes through, is able to avoid Anthony Epps, and goes up. Delk gets called for the foul, two foul shots.
And the first foul on Delk. You mentioned the separated shoulder last year for Neil Reed. He suffered the injury in November, played with it the rest of the year. Certainly hampered his shooting, and at times when it was painful to watch him play, but he wanted to continue to play. They needed him to with the lack of depth in the backcourt. He had surgery on that right shoulder right after the season ended.
He's been an Indiana fan since he's been a young kid. He was gone to camp. So this was like a dream for this young man. So that's why he played. It was just an opportunity he was not going to let slip by. But every time Indiana has made runs, Neil Reed has been in the middle of it in terms of handling the ball and making plays.
One out of two from the line for Reed. Indiana down by five. They're chipping away. They were down 10 moments ago. Mercer. Delk traveled. Got his step. And took a step. Sean McDonough, Quinn Buckner at the RCA Dome in Indianapolis. 41,071 in attendance here this afternoon to watch Kentucky and Indiana. 10 national championships combined between these two programs. And Kentucky has a 5-point lead with 14-10 remaining.
This team on the floor now, I think, is going to be a problem for Indiana. Without Neil Reed or somebody to control it, you can see the tempo is picking up every time they pass the ball where Kentucky wants it.
Mandeville lays it in off a nice bounce pass from Rolls, and the shot clock was under five.
Yeah, they were really in trouble trying to get a basket because they just don't have anybody out there that can do it out front. But Kentucky allowed them to get it inside.
And once again, Indiana scratched back in. Turner. Missed it.
Oh, no! Mr. McCarty.
And a foul in the backcourt against Kentucky. McCarty with 12 points now. It seems like all of them have been on lobs for a dunk or follows for a dunk.
Well, McCarty is a very active guy. You see right here, jump shot is going to go up. Now watch coming from the left side of your screen, number 40. Over the top, Chris Rolls is there. Charlie Miller, nobody can start Walter McCarty. Right there in your screen, right on the right side. I mean, it becomes a rub in, but the ball was a long way away from the basket for a dunk.
Well, Patino has said several times that McCarty can get his weight up to about 235. He thinks he could be a lottery pick for his ability to play inside and outside. The basket is waved off.
There's no way. The ball was in the air.
Now he says count it. After he conferred with his fellow officials, he said score the basket. Originally, Mike Sanzier waved it off, but that's good teamwork by the officials.
It's great teamwork because
partners came to his aid and they made the right call, which in the final analysis.
But you'll see, the ball is on the rim. He's right about the foul. Indiana definitely fouled because you can see right there in the screen, Eggers pushes on the back of Pritchard right there. But the ball it was on the rim when he made the call and he waved it off.
And the basket is good. 3-point lead for Kentucky. Down to 13 minutes remaining. Pope for three. Air ball.
You know, I'm wondering how much, you only can wonder a kid like Mark Pope. He's been starting. You know, he didn't start today. You wonder how much in a big game like Indiana, him not starting has affected him because he shot two today that hadn't been close, but he's capable of making a shot out there.
Evans fouled by Pope. Three-pointer would have tied up the game for Indiana, but Evans will have two free throws and a chance to get the Hoosiers within one.
Well, you know, Bob Knight wants his team, I think, to be aggressive. You and I talked about this at halftime, but what Indiana has done a very good job of is they've attacked this press. Here, I thought Wilkerson just got away with getting the ball turned over, but you can see Evans takes it to the basket strong. Pope tries to get over to block the shot. With McCarty out of the game, it's a problem. Pope picks up his fourth, but they didn't have anybody to block shots. That's why McCarty's back in.
Evans made the first free throw. Talked about Pope coming off the bench. In the past, Rick Pitino has preferred to use him that way because he is so foul prone. We want him around late in the game. He tends to pick up early fouls when he starts. So through most of his career, Kentucky's been a bench player.
Yeah, but a game like this, he would want to start.
Steal. And then taken right back by Epps. Delk with the one-hander. Indiana had the ball momentarily, and had they been able to hang on and score, they would have had the lead for the first time. They still have not led, and the Kentucky advantage now is three, under 12 and a half minutes remaining. Rolls nicely through the traffic. Wilkerson out of bounds off Kentucky. IU will play it in.
Kentucky did a very good job getting back defensively on that one. I thought Chris Rolls made some mistake, throws the ball late. But you like Kentucky, they get beat. They will come back and make plays on the backside.
Rolls, known as an excellent defender. Coach Knight has compared him to former IU guards Chris Reynolds and Jamal Meeks. Evans missed a three-pointer that would have tied the game.
Got to go down to Antoine Walker. Charlie Miller is trying to guard Walker, and I don't think he can guard him.
Delk missed a three. A three-pointer would tie it for Indiana. Under 12 minutes remaining. A little bit sloppy with the dribble. Rolls, and now a mad scramble and a held ball. And on the alternating possession, Indiana will get it after a TV timeout. With 11:50 remaining here in Indianapolis.
Timeout.
It's been closely contested throughout, as you'd expect when Kentucky plays Indiana.
How to achieve success.
For me, it's the details. In golf, that means taking it one stroke at a time. And at Jiffy Lube, we do it one car at a time. And we offer the quality of Pennzoil. So even though we've serviced almost 100 million cars, the one that matters most is the one we're working on now.
If it doesn't say Jiffy Lube, it just isn't Jiffy Lube.
In shopping for a luxury performance sedan, Jay Kerness tested the Oldsmobile LSS against the fastest, most nimble machine on earth, Juma the Cheetah. The LSS's sport suspension and traction control attacked the course, as did the Cheetah. But while he considered the LSS's precise handling quite impressive, there was one thing he failed to consider. Cheetahs are very sore losers. Will the LSS pass your test?
Nice kitty. Go away.
Once upon a time, three girls went to Rocksteady for a pickup game.
Yo! We got next!
Lisa is the center of U.S. women's basketball team. Cheryl's a forward. Dawn is a point guard.
Shoot that, Cheryl. Take the jump, Lisa. We'll take it.
And this isn't a fairy tale, so they didn't beat every guy, but they beat enough to say, basketball is basketball, athletes are athletes.
Jesse, you're next.
I'm all yours.
Save it for the stage, Romeo.
Carol always gives it to me straight. Like when she told me about my...
I told him about Head & Shoulders. Regular shampoos just rinse flakes away so they could come back. Head & Shoulders helps prevent flakes from even forming. You see the difference? You look great.
Thanks, but will it get me this part?
Couldn't hurt.
Head & Shoulders, because great hair can't have flakes.
Hey, break a leg.
That was the scene moments ago during the TV timeout. Flags coming from every entrance to the court as the cheerleaders ran. What a terrific scene. Looked like the opening ceremonies of the Olympics.
Oh, it was something to see. The fanfare with all of the energy. That's what I love about college basketball.
Now, if only we could get people in these two states to care about college basketball, this rivalry really might become something.
A sea of blue and red is all we got here.
Evans blocked out of bounds by Prickett.
with a very good defensive play there, because Evans had beat the two defenders that trapped him, and Prickett bailed him out.
An interesting career for Jared Prickett as a freshman in 93, a big part of their run to the Final Four. And last year, he was not as much of a factor. That's a travel. Miller cognizant of the fact the shot clock was running out.
Well, the question is, he goes up and he really just loses the ball. Yep. What he tried to do, though, is make it look as though it got hit by Antoine Walker, and the officials make the right call. They just let it go because Antoine went straight up with his arm.
Kentucky by three. Nearing the midpoint of the second half. Long three for Anderson. And a good rebound by Miller. He's big for a guard at 6'7". Evans got the bounce.
Well, I mean, that had to have a soft touch because he took a tough shot with Anderson all over him.
It's a one-point game. Evans is 25, 6 here in the second half. Walker, they've been the main man. Evans of Indiana and Walker for Kentucky.
Tell him, this Anderson is very, very good. I mean, he got back to get his hands on that ball to make that play. But, you know, Brian Evans is being guarded by Anderson. And look, he's all the way around. I mean, they're fighting for it. Prickett steps up late, but this one has a touch and fortunately goes in for Indiana. But I'm telling you, Anderson is guarding Evans about as well as you can guard a man.
As Rick Pitino said this morning, it looks like watching Indiana on tape that they run so many plays for Evans, much like they did for Calvert Chaney a couple of years ago.
Calvert Chaney, Scott May, Steve Alford, you go down the line. The shooters always get the picks for them, particularly when they're seniors.
Did they run many for you?
No, I was the guy throwing the ball.
Well, you scored a few, as we mentioned, number 24 all time on the scoring list. That's a charge. Miller's made a couple of costly mistakes in the last couple of possessions as he ran over Jeff Shepard that time.
But you could see all day long that it was there. Watch, he makes the move, and right away Shepard knows he's going to the left. See, Anderson it is that time. Knew he's going to the left hand. If he goes right-handed, he has a chance to avoid that, and Anderson anticipated him coming to the left. Good defensive play gets Charlie Miller, his third personal foul.
Substitution. He was a great scorer in high school, was Miller. Patterson comes back into the game with three fouls. Miller led the state of Florida in scoring as a high school senior, averaged 33 points per game, but he hasn't been able to establish himself as a scorer at the collegiate level yet.
It's a lot different, you know, scoring in high school than when you get up here and play against this kind of talent on the collegiate level, Division I.
Anderson. And finally, the Cats get a three-pointer to go. They're just 3-for-12 from three today. That trifecta gives them a six-point lead. Reed again looking to push. More than midway through the second half now. 9:42 remaining. Kentucky leads 68-62. Wilkerson.
The same play he got the shot on before. He goes down under the pick and come back. And that time it was Epps that couldn't get over the top side.
Sharon has 4 points. Couldn't mention them. Two identical field goals.
Anderson's filling it. When he let that go, there's an air about a guy when he knows he's got it going, and Anderson just had it going that way.
And a great hustle by Epps trying to save it along the end line. Derek Anderson with consecutive three-pointers now has 12 points for the Cats, and their lead has gone back to 7.
Well, you got to know coming behind you is going to be a Wildcat. You see Epps coming in your living room, taking a little dive. Didn't come up with that one. I'd give him about a 6.4 on that one. Not much form on that guy.
Patterson for three. Caught by Evans. And a foul on Shepard as he put the body on Evans.
Well, I tell you, that's a tough shot to see coming out. You know, Patterson comes in and takes a difficult shot. Shepard gets called for the foul because he backed under Brian Evans as he was going for that rebound.
Mouye Zinovich returns, and Mandeville gave them some good minutes. Goes to the Indiana bench, not a shooting foul. And on the next foul committed by Kentucky, each team will be in the bonus situation. Indiana has already committed 7 this half. 8:50 remaining. Reed. Double team now, and that was a kick ball by Anderson. Went out of bounds. Indiana will play it in with 17 on the shot clock.
Very good defense right there. Bob Knight is telling Neil Reed, you got him in the air, you got to draw the foul. Because he had him the only position he could get him because the corner, he couldn't get around the corner. But Kentucky is covering up from one another very well.
Wilkerson left alone, and it was way off. But Bujezinović there to follow, and he has 6 points. Anderson nearly got caught in the air. Cricket missed the left-hander. Bujezinović. Kentucky by five. Indiana has the ball with 8:07 remaining.
You wonder, when does the leg start to become a factor in the game? And I suspect in the next 3 minutes, we'll determine whether or not it will be a factor. I think it will be for Kentucky because they're in great shape. And Indiana looks like they're slowing it down and not cutting as hard off the kick.
Pace has not been as quick here in the second half. Wilkerson's pass intercepted. And Epps left alone to lay it in.
See, those are two examples. There's a weak pass, and Anderson and Patterson make a very poor attempt to go get it, and nobody gets back. Those are examples that your legs are going.
And Shepard is applying the body all the way up the court, and he's called for the foul. His second.
You wonder about legs. Watch, there's no attempt made by Patterson, and then here's the getting back. There's Sharon Wilkerson trying to get back, but there's no chance he's going to catch Anthony Epps get back for that move. 2 points.
Both teams in the bonus now. Each team has committed 7 points here in the second half. It's Sharon Wilkerson at the free throw line. He's no relation to the former Hoosier. Bobby Wilkerson was a member of the Hoosiers' undefeated national championship team, 75-76. Block, McCarty. Knocked away the shot of Bujezinović, and that went out of bounds off Bujezinović, and Kentucky will play it in after a TV timeout. 7:32 remaining in Indianapolis. The Wildcats lead by 7.
If you can't wait till the big day to peel off the wrapping, McDonald's has some appealing news. We're going to give you a break. The Monopoly game is back for the holidays, bigger and better, with over 100 million prizes. Buy one of these food favorites and get 2 chances to win. Collect and win, or win instantly. You could win $1 million, a Dodge Viper. Fabulous food prizes. Sound appealing? Then get to Mickey D's before the holiday Monopoly game is gone.
Have you had your break today?
Hi, Julie, we've been expecting you.
Todd, to reception, please.
You have a guest.
Julie.
Hi, Todd.
Are you excited?
I'm excited.
What do you say we go look at your car?
I'd love it. Okay. Is that my car?
This is Julie, and this is her first new car.
Shaving can strip away your skin's moisture, leaving it dry, burning. But now you can take the heat out of shaving with new Old Spice Soothing Gel, an amazing 2-in-1 gel that combines aftershave and moisturizer into one soothing formula. Try it. If you don't think this makes your face feel great, call 1-800-PROVE-IT for a full refund. Prove it to yourself. Try new Soothing Gel. It takes the heat out of shaving. And now you've got proof. Guaranteed.
Express yourself
with EOS lenses and the Rebel X from Canon.
Enterprise, hi, I'm at the repair shop. I need to rent a car.
Enterprise will arrange to pick you up.
This is great.
Drive you to our place and get you on your way. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Sean McDonough, Quinn Beck, Buckner back here in Indianapolis, where Kentucky leads by 7. Before the break, we made a reference to Bobby Wilkerson, a member of the undefeated national championship team for Indiana. It was 20 years ago that you were a part of a team that went 32-0, the last team to go through the season undefeated and win the national championship on the men's side, of course. UConn did it for the ladies last year.
Yeah, they're having a little reunion for the team this Thursday, as a matter of fact, down in Bloomington, Indiana. It'll be good to see some of the guys. That's it. frankly, that's a long time ago. I don't remember a lot about it.
Rick Pitino didn't like the call. He thought Indiana deflected that pass out of bounds. But the officials say no. Indiana will play it in. It's 7:18 left. And Kentucky leading 73-66. Bob Knight remembers it. And he says even though he thinks there are more excellent players in this day and age in college basketball than there were 20 years ago, that your team would still be as successful today. Evans missed a three. Mujezinovic, tough shot, got it to go.
That's what he brings to the team. But you know, going back to what Bob Knight said, and the essence of it is true. People have changed, but the game hadn't changed. And you know, that, and I don't disagree with that at all. We played well enough that we might have been able to beat some teams. Going undefeated with this kind of talent is a whole other subject.
Walker a miss. Anderson had the rebound.
Oh, Evans picked up his fourth. Evans.
And that's a big call, and it looked to be the correct call. Anderson had the rebound cleanly and then was bumped. And that's four on Evans.
Well, Brian Evans is the guy that's been keeping Indiana in the game, more so in the first half than in the second half, but you can't afford to get him in foul trouble. Number 34, you see him go forward, and you see Anderson come backwards. There's no doubt about it. The foul is appropriately called, and Evans picks up his fourth.
Derek Anderson at the free throw line.
And Derek Anderson shoots 1-1. He transferred from Ohio State following the 93-94 season, sat out last year. Of course, it made a big impression on the Kentucky coaching staff in the 93 Maui Invitational, when four Ohio State scored 23 points against the Cats.
Well, they're also familiar with him because he's from Louisville, so they've been able to see him quite a few times.
In fact, he's heading to Louisville out of high school. And then when Jimmy Jackson opted to leave Ohio State to the NBA, saw the opening there for playing time right away and decided to go to Ohio State. It didn't work out there, and he transferred to Kentucky. 6:25 remaining. Kentucky leads by 7.
That's a 5-second call. You get it without a dribble, and Andre Patterson, clearly, you have to say his head's not in the game, and I think enough that Bob Knight's going to make a decision to get him out of it, but he's just standing there. If you're standing with the ball and not without a dribble, once he picked it up, he had 5 seconds to make a play. He didn't. Antoine Walker is excited about the defensive play he makes to get the turnover for Kentucky.
Robbie Eggers has replaced Patterson. Now 17 turnovers committed by Indiana. They had only 8 in the first half. X scored 3. Following the rebound action. And it's against Kentucky, and again, Rick Pitino did a dance on the sideline.
But I told you when we talked to him, remember, as we talked to him earlier this morning, and you're watching now, they're just two different, you know, you can see the facial change on both he and Bob Knight. They make that call, I believe, on Tony Delp. Always involved in the game, always teaching, and just emotionally just.
Delp was his third. Of course, Rick Pitino was partially blamed for the loss against UMass the other night because he's an alumnus of UMass and was on the committee when they selected John Calipari as the coach. They had a deal with Coach Calipari but couldn't come up with enough money to get him. And Rick Pitino said, I'll give the university $5,000 extra. That was what Calipari needed to take the job. If you'll give this man the job, he wrote the check. They hired Calipari. We know what John has done at UMass, Rick Pitino's alma mater. The other night, Rick lost to his alma mater.
Well, he knew he was a good coach, and that's why he fought for him at UMass.
No basket. Whistle for a foul away from the ball. Anderson made a three that does not count. It's on Neil Reed. Of course, every time the whistle blows now, the Hoosier fans will hold their breath because Evans has been left in the game with 4 fouls by Coach Knight with 6 minutes left. Foul on Reed, his first. Delson makes the first. 1-1. Coming up next, it's the Riders Ladies Skating Championships Part 2. Competition features Nancy Kerrigan and Katarina Vitt from the Rosemont Horizon in Chicago. That's next on CBS Sports.
Bob Knight takes a chance here. There's no question about it. You keep Brian Evans in here, you risk losing him. But I think he's got a senior. Now, this is the fifth year senior. He's been there for a while. And he knows that Bob Knight knows he has no chance without this young man in the game. And as you get closer, you got to wonder, does he take him out for a break? I think you do.
In Kentucky by 7. 5:45 remaining. 10 times Indiana has climbed to within a point in this game, but they have not been able to take the lead. Evans, a little bit quieter here in the second half, as you'd expect after a 19-point first half.
But also, Kentucky's paying a great deal more attention on him, to him. And Anderson has been able to guard him. And Sharon Wilkerson locks down a three with the time clock running down.
Clock was at two. And Wilkerson banged in a three-pointer. And it's a four-point game with 5:15 remaining. McCarty bumped on the drive by Mujezinovic. And that is his fourth. So Evans is playing with four, and now Mujezinovic has collected his fourth.
He's trying to play defense out on the perimeter. Just about all of Kentucky's players, you know, we were talking about UCLA being able to have people that can catch and make plays. Just about all of Kentucky's players can catch the ball and make a move off the dribble. You can see Kentucky's 10 for 10 this half.
And they've now made 13 in a row, dating back to the first half. For the game, they're 16 out of 19 from the line.
Well, they haven't been shooting the ball from the line that well. They're only about a 65% shooting team.
One out of two that time. The streak ends at 13. And Neil Reed got it over to Evans. And he has cooled off in a big way. Dealt the rebound. Mujezinovic took it away. Didn't get the bounce. Out of bounds. Indiana ball. Mujezinovic was poked in the eye. Mentioned that he has just taken off a mask that he wore in the first four games. He was injured in practice, took a shot in the maximum bone.
You can see how tough he is too.
Yes.
I mean, he got up. Now you can see he knocks the ball loose, does Harris. He tries to take it up, partially blocked there by McCarty. Then the action there, look a little on the back, and it was Tony Duck who actually on a follow-through accidentally poked him in the eye.
Well, he actually cracked the bone above his upper teeth, part of the upper jaw. Max Millabone, they told us yesterday, was the name of that part. And he's wearing a protective mask, looked like Jason from the movies. Reed missed a three-pointer. McCarty the rebound.
This is what Kentucky will get you when you give them numbers like this.
Kentucky leads by five. Anderson trying to make it eight, missed a three, got his own rebound.
And that'll kill you. When you let a man take a jump shot and then you allow him to get the ball back, that'll kill you.
And the lead is back to seven. Anderson has 12 points this half. And 16 for the game.
That plea was from this play. It was to Neil, block out. You see Neil Reed goes out to try to get to the shot. He doesn't get there. Anderson, as I said, best player they have on both sides of the ball, comes up with it after a long shot, very difficult play. He makes it look easy. Bob Knight telling Neil Reed, you gotta block out.
The first free throw attempt of the season for Robbie Eggers. The foul on Delp was his fourth. So Delp and Pope of Kentucky have four fouls each. And Eggers has his third point of the game. Robbie's a sophomore from Cuyahoga Falls, Ohio. Didn't play much.
They gave him the ball. He can't come in. They gave him the ball. And John Clarkety rightfully is stopping him. Once you give the young man the ball, you can't let him come in the game. You can't let the guy who's trying to come in this case, Antoine Walker, come into the game.
Might have bothered Eggers. Momentary delay. Missed the second. 4:25 remaining. Kentucky with the ball and a 6-point lead.
Point if you're Kentucky, you run your offense and you just try to make sure you get good shots. No need to be in a hurry.
Next one right by Reed, and we're fouled by Reed. Second on Neil Reed. Brian Evans, after the 19-point first half, during which he went 7 for 10 from the floor, is only 2 of 8 here in the second half.
Couple of reasons. One is I think he's a little tired. But yeah. Two, I guarantee you, Rick Pitino went in and because he had told these guys about it. That's why Derek Anderson was put on him at the beginning, as you and I talked to Rick this morning, was for defensive purposes. And Anderson let him get away, and I'm sure he heard an earful at halftime.
Epps be two shots the rest of the way for Rick Pitino's team as Indiana has committed 10 team fouls this half. Epps, best free throw shooter on the team last year, 85%. Made both on this trip. 9 points, five assists for Epps, who got the start today at point guard. And the lead is eight. Time running out on Indiana. 4 minutes left.
Well, you can see when they run people at Evans now, they're a lot bigger, like Antoine Walker's guarding.
Evans missed again. Pope the rebound. Walker gave it back to Epps.
Smart play. Good patience.
Delph. And a good rebound by Reed. 3.5 minutes remaining. Still Kentucky by 82-74.
If you look at the pace of Indiana as compared to the first half, you don't see them necessarily. That's the first time they've really beaten anybody off the dribble. That's a sign of legs, too. You don't beat people that way because you're tired, you just don't have the energy. Rick Pitino decided he wants a timeout.
With 3:11 remaining, CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
You should have seen me in this car, honey.
I took our new Pontiac Grand Am to the beach today.
I was all over town in this baby.
The new twin cam engine. Oh, and then there were these guys that were admiring me.
Who are these guys?
Very cool interior. They had so much fun. Did I tell you about the way that people were checking me out?
You are talking about the car.
Ooh, I loved it so much that I think I need to go out again.
No.
The new Pontiac Grand Am. It makes the ordinary extraordinary.
This is CBS.
Insurance means safety and security. For more than 50 years, Kentucky Farm Bureau Insurance has provided that peace of mind for thousands of families. When you need insurance coverage for your home, farm, car, or boat, life, or health, call your local Kentucky Farm Bureau agent. To get the most for your insurance dollar, ask about our multi-policy discounts. We can provide a quote for all your insurance needs. Kentucky Farm Bureau Insurance. All-around coverage, all around Kentucky.
Your closet knows everything.
Been gift shopping? Not a very good start. Better head for Jacobson's. It's a real gift to have Jacobson's help you choose just the right things. And if it's not just the right thing, well, don't worry. It's from Jacobson's. They'll exchange it. Way to go, Erica. Wonder if there's anything in there for me.
Jacobson's.
Jake's.
Listen to your closet.
Ho, ho, ho.
Cancer. It can affect so many parts of our bodies. Our lives. The physicians and staff of Norton Hospital Cancer Treatment Center are experts on today's treatment options for all types of cancer and are busy researching the breakthroughs of tomorrow. Norton Hospital Cancer Treatment Center. When it comes to cancer treatment, it's the natural choice.
I'm Steve Briggs. Expect the high on Sunday of 60 degrees. More news and weather coming up.
6 point lead for Kentucky, 3:11 remaining. Big part of Kentucky's ability to maintain the lead, their free throw shooting here in the second half. They're 13 out of 14. Ryan Evans, after 19 point first half, has cooled off here in the second. And we're down to 3 minutes left. The CBS Sports Show comes your way following this game. Leaner by Anderson, wouldn't go, but Walker wound up with the ball and dropped it in. And Antoine Walker is 22.
But Anderson makes the play because he missed the shot and he was able to get there again to make a nice little tap.
And Wilkerson did not score in the first half, has 9 here in the second half. The lead 6 for Kentucky. 2:33 left.
Kentucky can always go inside to Antoine Walker, but nobody's guarding him well all night, all afternoon. He can always look for a basket there. They've cleared out their offense inside, and that's the way they can get their offense.
That time he scored over Miller. Walker's 10 out of 12 from the floor. Miller lost the handle as did Epps, but dealt there to play in the corner. And the way this game has gone, it's tough to turn any comfortable in a number of spurts by each team, but Kentucky looks comfortable at the moment. McCarty had it rattle out. The lead 8 for UK with 1:57 remaining. And a foul on McCarty on the rebound. His second personal. And that gets Kentucky to 10 team fouls in the half, and Indiana will shoot 2 the rest of the way. Belt and Pope have been playing with 4, as have Evans and Mujezinovic.
Well, I would say that it would be Kentucky can easily lose either one of those guys and not be as nearly as affected by that loss as Indiana would with both of their guys. So Harris is, as well as Brian Evans have both been factors for Indiana.
Wilkerson to shoot 2. He has 9 points and 6 assists. Coming off a career high 14 points earlier this week in the win in Bloomington over Notre Dame. He also had 9 rebounds in that game.
Well, he's also a young man, if you look at Todd Linderman, who hadn't played in a year. You well know he broke his leg and then had to sit out. And so, it looks like he's starting to wear a little bit of rust off of his game.
Fortunately, has not had any problems with the leg this season. He made 1 out of 2. And the lead 7 for the Cats with a minute 46 left.
When you think about Indiana, they got blown out basically by Kentucky. Connecticut. Duke did a good job against them. And you come in here and you think about on paper teams, and this rivalry, you pretty much can kind of throw that to the wind.
That's what Rick Pitino said this morning. Anderson with a shot clock at 2. Blocked by Evans. And it is a violation
absolutely
of the shot clock.
Yeah. It didn't get to the rim or wasn't in the air out of a hand before the shot clock goes. That's a violation.
Coach Knight wants a timeout. His players didn't see him as they inbounded. Now he's changed his mind. He's taking a seat.
This is a valuable possession. That's why he's trying to get a timeout. They need to get either a foul shot or a basket from here.
Reed for a 3 they need. Yeah, wouldn't go.
Yeah, because now you're down to a minute. Get that basket down too.
And with the lead, Kentucky will push if it's there. Delk missed the shot and was lost out of bounds by Anderson, but a foul called against Indiana for a shove into the back of Anderson. I believe it's Charlie Miller guilty of the push. It is.
Yeah, that was a basket that if they get to go down, they're down 7, they get a chance at it. But once they lose that one, you've got 56 seconds to put you in a real difficult position. You see, Evan splits the defense, and that's what allows, first of all, the shot to be thrown over. Wide open is Neil Reed, and he just didn't get it to go down. You got a wide open shot, Neil Reed can make it, and it didn't go. You got to wonder, was it legs? Because the shot was short.
Coming up on the CBS Sports Show, figure skating, Nancy Kerrigan and Katarina Witt featured, and also the Ford Taurus College Football Report. That's coming up at the end of this game. Kentucky leads by 9 with 50 seconds left.
And they just shot great from the foul line this half. Double dribble.
Yeah. Good. Mujezinovic didn't understand the call at first. And it looks like Kentucky has rebounded nicely from the disappointment, the loss to Massachusetts earlier this week.
They put a lot of pressure on you, Sean. They just keep coming at you, and with new players, different schemes. You notice they didn't put much full court pressure in the second half, save their legs, because Rick Pitino knew his team was in a fight, and he wanted to make sure that his legs were fresh.
Corey Patton said on the first game, even though Kentucky lost to an excellent UMass team the other night, he thinks Kentucky has the most talent and is the best team, and will be, and I still agree with him.
I think they will be. I don't know if they are the best team yet, but I think they have the most talent. But because you have the most talent, if you don't have chemistry, it doesn't mean you have the best team.
Traveling the call against Anderson. And Rick Pitino wants a 20-second timeout. Not fully comfortable with the 9-point lead, 14.8 seconds left. The genuine Chevrolet players of the game are Antoine Walker from Kentucky, 24 points, 7 rebounds. He's 10 of 12 from the floor. And Brian Evans, who brought Indiana back from the 14-point deficit in the first half, 19 first half points, 25 for the game. And Brian added 2 rebounds. In celebrating its 25th year of NCAA sponsorship, Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need.
You've got to say, coming off the loss, and I think you make a good point, this team, you can see emotionally, just got, they had a lot of bounce in their step in this game, and I know for Rick Pitino, that was important to make sure he had that. You know, because the team, when you got young people, you don't count on Mercer, you're going to count on Anderson a little bit, first-year player, newcomer. It's important you get them back up on stride. But he said, look, we lost the game. Now you understand we can lose if we don't play hard, smart all the time. And so I think, as you said, they've got a chance to be a really good team.
Dan Evans with a three and a quick timeout. With 6.9 seconds left, Kentucky leads by six.
Did you ever notice how many times a day you look at your watch? More women rely on a watch made by Citizen than any other timepiece. Because more women prefer a watch made by Citizen than any other timepiece on Earth. Citizen. How the world tells time.
If you ever end up in some Ben-Hur movie in your all-new Pontiac Sunfire GT, with its powerful twin-cam engine, you'll be glad you have a quick-handling sport suspension. And, of course, 150 horses. Introducing the all-new Pontiac Sunfire GT. Finally, a real set of wheels you can really afford.
No one can see you now.
Hey, bet we could.
Fools, we will defeat you and take your Miller Lite.
Not if we choose the weapon.
Paper football, very clever. You kick off.
It's good.
We are safe.
When you've got the great taste of an ice cold Miller Lite, life is good.
You are worthy opponents. Let us celebrate. I know a good sports bar around the corner. Life is good.
This week on Dave, Jim Carrey, Roseanne, John Travolta, Kim Basinger, Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, Brett Butler, Gabriella Sabatini, and Arnold Schwarzenegger. This week.
CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by the Citizen Watch Company. Citizen is how the world tells time. And by Pontiac and your local Pontiac dealer. We are driving excitement.
Quinn, I've been impressed for much of the day by Indiana, but they're going to have an excellent season. They need to get more out of some individual players, it would seem. Guys like Patterson and Miller, who have the ability, just aren't producing it.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about it. They've got to get that production for the extra scoring they're going to need to get.
I've got gigabytes, I've got megabytes. I'm voicemailed, I'm emailed, I surf the net, I'm on the web, I am Cyberman. So how come I feel so out of touch?
Are you free? Are you really free?
On the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
You know, sometimes being known as the parts expert can be mighty big shoes to fill. Of course, this time of year, I got some mighty big stockings to fill, too.
Come fill your stockings at Napa's Holiday Gift Sale, where you'll find great items at low prices. Like these Chilton repair manuals, just $15.99, and a Napa starter charger for only $39.99 after mail-in rebate. While you're here, apply for the Napa card, the new convenient way to pay at Napa.
We keep America running.
Seconds away from the CBS Sports Show featuring the Riders Ladies Skating Championships. Nancy Kerrigan and Katarina Vitt competing. Also coming up, the Ford Taurus College Football Report. That's in 7 seconds. Kentucky with the ball, leading by six, and a quick foul committed by Charlie Miller. And he is fouled out of the game.
Foul, Indiana, number three, Charlie Miller. That's his 10th personal.
Well,
He was telling Charlie Miller, they knew that play was coming, and he's telling him he's not reacting quick enough. And you and I were just talking about Charlie Miller. One of the things that it has to be, his reaction, recognition and reaction, as you talk to the coaching staff, has been the biggest issue, whether or not he sees things and then react to it. And that was one of those instances where he did not act fast enough based upon Bob Knight's thinking anyway.
We really didn't see Patterson after Coach Knight was very vocal in his displeasure. Patterson's play.
But I have to say this, if Indiana, because Kentucky is a good team, as we've stated, if Indiana plays with this effort and improves, they'll be a factor. Because I frankly, coming into this game, did not think they would do that well, this well. And I mean, obviously the game seemed to be pretty much in hand for Kentucky. I didn't think Indiana would do this well, but I just didn't think they would handle the pressure of Kentucky.
Shepard made one out of two. And Wilkerson missed a long three at the buzzer. Sigh of relief from Coach Pitino, and Kentucky is now in four of the last five in this border rivalry. Kentucky now 2-1, Indiana 2-3. The final score, the Wildcats 89, the Hoosiers 82. For Quinn Buckner, Sean McDonough saying so long from Indianapolis. Stay tuned for the CBS Sports Show.